my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you like makeup, colorful, neutral, drugstore and indie, a little bit of weirdness, some sarcasm strewn here and there, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button because we are in December and I upload a lot. Yes. Okay. Today... I am pre-filming. I have tried to film my intro, I think, 10 times, and it's just... This is how it's going to be today. I am going to talk about 10 green eyeshadow palettes, or at least there are 8 green ones and 2 bonus. But I wanted 10. I'm also going to rank them, and I think it will be a fun video. Yeah, you know, let's just get into it, because I will tell you why they are where they are and why they are in the video while I'm ranking them. Before I forget though, the makeup I have on my face is the Mitchell palette, the, what is it, Feet on the Ground palette. And my sweater, because I know some of you asked, is from the brand Only, but I got it at a thrift store, so I don't know how old it is. I don't know if it's still available. That's it. So yeah, let's just, I don't know what's happening, go into the ring. Oh yeah, and the nails, they are glue-on nails, and I bought a set at a local... It's almost a dollar store. So I don't know where they are from either. But I do really, really like them. So yeah, let's get into the video. Let's start with number 10. And number 10 is at this place for several reasons. Let me show you number 10. That's this one. It is the Quad from Extra Revolution in the shade Extortion. It is an all shimmer palette and I did not really know when I bought it. I thought that these two were mattes. They are not. Also... When I bought this in the summer, this shade, it kind of melted. It was really, really weird. Now, though, it has set again. So, yeah, if you have this quad or something similar and you're like, I can push the shimmer around, I don't know, put it in the fridge, you know, see how it behaves then. But yeah, it's an all shimmer palette. I really do like the colors that are in here, but because it's an all shimmer palette, I don't grab it. And that is why it is at number 10. Let's next go to number 9 then. And number 9 is here because I have something similar, almost the exact same color story, in a formula that I prefer. That is ranked higher, and that is why it is here, because I almost never grab it. And that is the Avocado palette from iHeart Revolution. It is not a bad palette at all. I have had so much fun with this one. It's just that I have a palette that is almost the same color story, and I prefer that formula over this one. And that is the only reason it is ranked here at this place, number 9. Number 8 is here because it is, well, maybe it should technically not be in here because it does not have more greens than any other shade. It's basically half-half, if you stretch it a little bit. But it is a palette that I want to grab, but I don't grab often. Because if I grab it, there is a specific color story that I, specific color combination that I go for. And that is it, I think. It is the Oceanic from Ace Beauté. Now, this is basically a green-blue palette. But I did want to pull it in because I did want to show you. I do really like the quality of this. It is very, very pigmented. It's just that the colors that I am drawn to are here. Where are we? Here. This is what I want to play with every time I open up the palette. This part. So I don't grab it often. Maybe it is also the time of year, because now that I'm looking at it, I'm like, ooh, I kind of want to use it again. But yeah, it's number 8 because I don't grab it a lot. I do want to though, but yeah, I have other palettes that I grab before this one. That is it. I do, as I said, I do like the quality. Then number 7, right? Yes, is this one from Kaleidos, the Sci-Fi Green. Let me open it. And so you let me go like this. Can we go like this? Sure we can. I actually glued the shade names on the mirror because I don't use the mirror anyway. But here she is. And she is largely green. It is largely a green palette. Yes, this matte is a little bit more orangey. But overall it is predominantly green. I love that word so much. It is a green palette. The only thing that it is down here is basically because of the formulation. I don't think that the quality is bad, but it is a stiffer formula, and for me, it is a little bit harder to work with. I remember when this launched, everyone was raving about Kaleidos. There was a specific idea that I had in my head that their formula would be like, and when I worked with this one, their formula wasn't that. Again, it is not a bad formula, but it is a little bit stiffer, and it is a little bit... I won't say harder to work with, but I have to blend more than 2 minutes. You know, that is kind of what I mean. So I do really like the color story. It is my kind of neutrally greenish palette. But yeah, the reason that it is down here is because I don't find the formula that good to work with. That's it. Yes. That's it. It's number 6 now, right? 10, 9, 8, 7. Yes, number 6. Number 6 is also an interesting color story. It's not a completely green palette, but it's largely a green palette. And it is from Lucky Bunny Cosmetics. It is her first palette, The Envy. She's doing the 7 Deadly Sins, and this was her first palette. She's based in Australia. I do have a discount code with her, but I did pay for this palette myself. And this is the color story. So basically you have all greens or almost all greens, but also some other shades in between. It's such an interesting color story, and this is the reason that I bought it, because specifically because of this part in here that I was so intrigued by. That is why I bought it, and I fell in love with her brand and with her formula. This is a very, very nice quality. I loved playing with this palette. It is just here because it is a palette that I'm not grabbing for a lot. Because there are other palettes that I want to play with a little bit more. That are maybe a little bit more unique in my collection. Because while this is a largely green palette, these are also shades that I have in other palettes. So yeah, that is it, I think. Yeah, there are just other palettes that I grab for before this one, if that makes any sense at all. Okay, I will also link a bunch of videos in the description box and underneath the cards. I have done videos with all the palettes that... No, I'm lying. I have done videos with almost all the palettes. So yeah, there's that. The next one, number 5, is a palette that is maybe not a completely green palette. It is, well, half, if I stretch it a tiny bit. But it is one of my favorite palettes that I have here. And it is just a palette that I really, really want to use. And if I'm being completely honest now that I'm looking at it, the shades that I go for most in this palette are the greens. Just saying. It is the Tribe palette by Juvia's Place. I'm going to blind you probably because of the shine. But here she is. Now this, where are we? This shade, yeah, you know, it's not really green. But I'm counting it as a green. I really, really do love this palette. I have to be honest and say that if I grab this palette, I usually play here and pull in that green. Because that is, but also this row... This is not specifically unique to my collection. Well, maybe this shade. This row is though, and so is this row. So I really, really like this palette. Hence the fact that it is maybe not a completely green palette or an overly green palette. But it has green packaging, so that is going to count as well. It is my number 5. Yes. Then number 4 is... Yeah. Number 4 is here because it's just... It's the cute factor, guys. It's the Yoda palette. I have not played with it as of yet. But this is the cardboard for the cardboard palettes from Colourpop. I really like the formula of, with the exception of the Good Sport palette, which I really did not like and I decluttered. But overall, I do really like them. And I have heard great things about this formula. And I don't feel like I'm going to struggle with this. But it's just the cute factor put it here. It's just... Look, it is also, oh, I need to go like that. No, this hand, look, it is even a Yoda. Never mind. You know, that is what happens to me and this palette. That is why it is here. I really want to play with it, but I haven't had the time just yet. It's, even if the formula is shit, it would still be here, guys. It's I'm just a sucker for. Look at this cute little nose. Let's go. Let's move on, shall we? Yeah. Then we are at my top three. Now, my top three, I have played with all the palettes. Yeah, that's it. I have played with all the palettes. My number three is maybe something that will surprise you if you see it. It is this from Nomad Cosmetics. This was the only thing that I got in PR. I also have a discount code with Nomads. Nomad Cosmetics, by the way. Yes, that was it. This is the quad called Malibu Surf Shack. It is from their California collection. Now, when I look at this in the viewfinder, you can kind of see the green. Because this is a green palette, even though it may not look it. The only shade that is not green is this one. This is, as you can see, a minty. Then this is almost a dark olive. And this is even darker. They look brown, but truly, when you see them, let me see if I can show you. Can you see that they are green? They're terrible swatches though. Let's see if I can kind of build them up a bit so you can see better. Here are the two darkest mattes. They are green. It is just a very, I don't know, almost a swampy look that you get with this. This is one of my favorite eyeshadow formulas. I really, really love this quad a lot. I don't grab for it right now, but this is a quad that I grab for if I just want something effortless and something pretty. It's definitely worth checking out. Also, if you kind of want to get the same vibe, they're not the same, but you can get a little bit of the same vibe out of it, you know? In case you are curious about one or the other. Okay, now we are at my top two. And my second favorite palette is a palette that I have had a lot of... Oh, I'm itchy. Yes. That I have had a lot of fun with as well. I have done a bunch of videos with. It is the So Dope palette by Makeup Obsession. And this is the reason that the Avocado palette is where it is. Because I really, really, really do like this color story a lot. The quality is very, very nice. It is also one of my favorite qualities. One of my favorite formulas that I have here. It is this shade Stone. I think is my favorite in the palette. This is just, I live for shades like this. So pretty. It is just so pretty. And a very, very nice alternative for the Jafar Sprinkle Fishes green palette. It's also a reason that I'm doing this video. Just saying. To give you options, guys. So yeah, very, very good quality. In my opinion, at least. Then my number one is the palette that I think of when I think of a green palette that I have in my collection. It's this palette. And then the So Dope palette is there because it's the second green palette that I think of. But this palette is the one that I think of when I think of a green palette in my collection. And that is this one. The Pistachio palette from BH Cosmetics. I have used her off camera. I have not filmed with it just yet. I will though, just because, you know, the reason that I haven't filmed with this is because a lot of people have filmed with it and it was sold out and wasn't available anymore. However, depending on when this video goes up, it is either, well, it's probably going to go up at the beginning of December. This should be restocked the 11th of December. Just saying. So yeah, I cannot wait to play with this. I really, really, this, the shade Crunch, which is the darkest, look, the darkest shimmer. Oh. Nom, 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 nom. It's just, I love this. I love this style. I love the fact that it is a matte and a corresponding shimmer. I love that format. But yeah, I think that is going to be it, guys. Yeah, from everything that I have in my collection right now, as I am filming this, this is my green palette video. That's it. Maybe I will rank kind of rainbowish palettes next. Maybe that will be fun. Oh, That's an idea. So yeah, this was it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Let me go to the site to give a special thank you to the members that you see scrolling on the screen. If you want to become a member, there's a link to join in the description box. There's also a link to my merch shop in case you want to get anything from there. Yes, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave because we are in December. December, it's the Dutch word for December. It's not that... There's not a lot of difference, but yeah. So I will upload regularly and I will upload a lot of different things. This type of video, but also my Let's Talk Makeup new releases will go online every Friday. And I will do eye looks. I will do get ready with me's. I'm also planning to do a vlog, but I don't know if I will succeed in that though. Let me know if you are interested. For now, I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.